Hey everybody, following up from my last video, I am loving this build and I'm even more of a fan now of the PB buckler here. This thing is unbelievable once you get good with the timing, at least for trades. So, a couple things I've learned from my playthroughs, and we'll get to the clips here, just showing off all of the perfect blocks that I'm able to do now, and this is just over the span of like 2 days. But it is extremely important to trade for the sweet 16 point blank. I've kind of noticed that now. Like, if you don't land this in your opening like exchange, it's better just to back off and go and attempt again because it's got a long cooldown. It's about 3 seconds. So this is extremely important. You gotta land this. It's both got an incredible amount of accumulative impact and impact. It also is your preferred option to follow up your triple dagger stab into a shotgun follow-up if you can. So ideally, if the fight's going on long and you manage to break them with the Zimmerman, then swap weapons before you start your dagger punish so you can follow up with the sweet 16 at point blank as well. It just adds another level to the punish. I also, and by the way, the buckler have actually been leaning more towards, even if they have damage over time weapons like SMGs and whatnot. I feel like this thing is so strong now once I've realized how powerful the 96 and 95% block is. I've tested it and you can actually block a double earshot blast. So if like they have two earshots on their shoulders, you can block it to almost nil damage and impact buildup if you perfect time it. Now obviously it's high risk, but honestly it doesn't feel that risky anymore now that I've gotten the hang of it. Certain weapons like lasers, you need to block as soon as you hear the first chime. Slower firing weapons like the earshots, you need to block. You just gotta like feel out, you'll feel out the timing, but it becomes very second nature, especially when you realize that you can practice, like I mentioned, my shield build IG flashing, so you get 0.6 seconds of IG duration instead of 0.3. You just flash it twice. That's the main limitation of the bucklers. You only get two flashes plus a third one if you're willing to wait a short amount of time. It just needs a little bit of recovery in order to earn that third block. Expansion-wise, I'm believing now that the terminal armor is just better unless they're using pulse armor. Even if they're using assault armor, because of how fragile this build is, yes, it's brainless. You can get the double stab, or sorry, the double punish with the dagger a lot easier, but I've just found it kind of slippery if they're in the air, which a lot of people will try to do. Like sometimes they'll start dropping at full speed. If they're a little bit slippery or too far away, sometimes they can activate their pulse armor out of range and they get away scot-free. So like the return on this is sometimes less. It's easier, but if you can master using the shield to block the assault armor, you can immediately re-stagger them because they only come back with like like most of their impact bar filled. So you just block and shotgun shot, and you get the stagger right back. So terminal armor seems to be the optimal option unless they're using pulse armor and you can stay close to them, in which case you can take assault armor. So other than that, oh yeah, I swapped out the headpiece. This gives you the option to equip the pulse blade. So there are certain builds that, and by the way, pulse blade with these legs, because I am leaning more towards these legs all the time now, just the jump distance is so good. But the pulse blade might be useful if you have, for whatever reason, like they're very short, like they're very quick to recover, like reverse joints. If you feel like they're going to get away a lot quicker and maybe evade some of the stabs, this has better lunge and the double slash occurs quicker, so you can get a more guaranteed punish with it. You just don't get the option to double punish, and you'll never get the option to use the charged dagger. So I would say that's the exception rather than the rule. You're almost always using the laser dagger. And I have been mixing in the charged laser dagger into my openings now. So what you'll do is land the sweet 16, go into charge dagger after swapping the weapon, and then you can shoot the Zimmerman to tr that'll be enough to stagger them, and then you can go into another dagger punish. So that's a really powerful mix-up too. Oh, and I guess yeah, I swapped the Zimmerman too. So again, swapping the headpiece gave me some options here. I think I was using this guy here originally, so I couldn't use the Zimmerman. A little bit heavier, has slowed us down slightly, but we're still above that speed breakpoint here. It's really not a problem. 376. The EN, I've suffered a little bit, but I feel like 57 is fine. Honestly, I mean, I thought 6,000 was where I wanted to keep it at, but this is fine. So you'll see it in the clips, and I just have a slew of perfect blocks to show you. PvP has been an absolute blast with this build. One just thing, if people start to go tanks against you, just swap the two shoulder pieces for laser missiles, either vertical if the map needs it or the quicker cooldown ones, and just alternate them with like about a 3 second break in between, just so that they're slowly building up impact and they never get the chance to let their impact recover because missiles keep hitting them alternating until they're at the point where you feel confident to approach them for a single shotgun into stagger break and then into your dagger punish. If they're running the appropriate expansion, then just bait that out, but don't actually go for your punish. They'll pop their armor while you double or triple quick burst with the Alulas out. That's a really nice thing about the Alulas. The short cooldown and long or high thrust means you can very quickly create a lot of space, enough to actually escape assault armor or at the very least take minimal damage from it. Okay, but yeah, let's get to the clips.
Thank you. Thank you.